Hi, today I'm Kalmar, Sweden, and we have a Seat Ibiza Mark IV. I'm going to show you how to change front brake pads and front brake disc. I'm going to start by raising the vehicle, remove two front wheels. I have removed the left wheel. Usually if there is a sensor on the brake pads, it will be on the left side. On this vehicle it's not equipped with a brake pad sensor. Now, as you can see, the brake discs are very bad damaged. I'm going to start by removing the brake caliper, remove the brake pads, and after that I will remove the brake disc. The brake caliper are holding two bolts with a 7mm hex wrench, and first I have to remove the plastic caps on the brake caliper, and the bolts are inside. Open the bolts, now I can remove the brake caliper. Now you can see that the brake pads are also in very bad condition. So now I'm going to remove the brake pads and I'm going to return the piston with a special tool. But it can be done with a screwdriver. You have anyone who has seen my videos can see that it can be returned with a screwdriver. I have removed the brake pads. Now you can notice these metal pins are different, so be careful when you install the new ones. This is coming from the brake piston and this is on the brake caliper. Now I'm going to remove the brake piston with this kind of tool. It's very easy to find and it's not that expensive, and it will do a lot of work. I'm going to turn like this and it's going to return the brake piston inside. I have returned the piston. Now I'm locking the caliper to stay here and I'm going to remove the disc. The disc is holding one bolt with torque started. And now I can remove the disc. If the disc is stuck, then I can hit it with a hammer on this side, because it doesn't matter, it's pretty much damaged. Now you can see at the back side it's even more. Now I'm going to install the new one. Here I have a new set of brake discs. Now you can see there is also a bolt that holds the disc. Inside is the other one. And we have brake pads. They are completely. These are for one side. These are for the other. So now I'm going to install the brake disc and brake pads. And next I'm going to install the brake pads on the brake caliper, and I can install the brake caliper. That will be something like this. And don't forget the metal pins on the brake pads to return them as they were before. And when you install the brake caliper, always take a notice on this metal pin, because that one has to go on this side of the bracket. So now I can tighten the two bolts with a 7mm hex wrench. I have tightened the brake caliper. Now I can return the two plastic caps. And now I can install the wheel. I have installed the wheel. Now, to shorten the video a little, because it's the same thing on the other side, I'm going to skip a little, because it's the same job. I just want to show you that how much the disc is damaged on this side. vehicle is on the ground, and before you start driving the vehicle, first press the brake pedal a couple of times so the brake caliper can adjust to the new brakes, because it's possible for brake pedal to go all the way down a couple of times. Now the brake is good and the vehicle is safe for driving, and this means I'm finished. If you like to see more videos, please subscribe to my channel. Also, don't forget to press on the notification bell to receive notifications when I upload new video, and thank you for watching.